India is currently battling a pandemic, it's battling high tensions at its borders with China, and at the same time, there's a surge in misinformation campaigns. So on this episode, we bust some of the misleading information that's going viral on the internet. First up is a social media, is a video that's been shared widely on social media, which shows hospital patients on beds outside of hospital. There are patients and their relatives are crowding around them, and they are on the roads outside a hospital. This footage is being claimed to be from Hyderabad Old City, and it shows the alleged coronavirus situation at that hospital, the lack of infrastructure because of the lack of beds, the footage claims. That people are forced to stay outside the hospital and wait for admission. However, this footage and the claim being made about this footage is actually false. The footage belongs to Lahore in Pakistan. It's from the Services Hospital in Lahore, where there was a fire at the surgical emergency ward, which is why the patients were evacuated, and they were there outside the hospital for some time. And according to Pakistani media, these patients are not COVID-19 positive either. Now, days ago, when Patanjali launched this Coronil medicine, which it claims to be a cure for COVID-19, that sparked a huge controversy. After that, of course, Ayush Ministry came out and said that it doesn't have details of the research and the evidence claimed by Patanjali, and then it sought the same from the company. Now what's going around on the internet is a claim by the CEO of Patanjali that the Ayush controversy has been settled. This email correspondence is being shared widely, and along with that, Acharya Balakrishna, the Patanjali CEO, claims that he's captioned the tweet as a resolution of the Ayush controversy. But this is being misread as the fact that Ayush Ministry has given the go-ahead for Coronil to be used as treatment for COVID-19. This is not the case. All this email correspondence says, if you read carefully, is that it has acknowledged, Ayush Ministry has acknowledged that it has received all the pertinent documents from Patanjali, and now it's going to validate whether or not Coronil can be used as a treatment. As of now, there has been no green signal from the center. Now, last week, PTI ran a report attributing it to RBI sources, claiming that Google Pay in India does not operate a payment system, that it does not find a place in the list of authorized payment system operators in India, and it's not in the list that is published by the National Payments Corporation of India. However, this turned out to be fake news. The RBI sources were the RBI sources attributed in that report were incorrect. It was misleading. Google Pay has come out with a statement last week. It said that it completely operates within the law. The insinuation made by that report was that if you're making payments or transfers via Google Pay, if any issue arises in those transfers, then you're not protected by law and you can stand to lose your money. However, this is fake news, and Google Pay has come out with this statement, and I quote, they said, "We work as a technology service provider to partner banks to allow payments via UPI. UPI apps in the country are categorized as third-party apps and are not required to be payment systems operators." So there is no worry if you're using Google Pay. Rest assured that your money is safe and protected by the law. And the same news has been clarified on the NPCI's website. And finally, last week, an image of Indira Gandhi, former Prime Minister of India, was shared widely, especially by Congress handles, claiming that she was addressing soldiers at the Galwan Valley, which is the site of a very deadly clash between Chinese and Indian soldiers. This picture is not from Galwan Valley, it's in fact from Leh in Ladakh. This picture was being shared by many Congress associated handlers to show how assertive India was before, and it was being shared to corner the central government above for allegedly surrendering Galwan Valley. However, this picture is not from the site of the clash, it's in fact from Leh. That's all this time. Thanks for watching.